that you're perturbing your brain with a chemical, but that you're meeting a being in a, on its own terms in another dimension. First of all, there are many aliens haunting the popular mind at the moment.
For instance, let's go through the four generic classes of aliens.
Okay.
The Pleiadians, the Arcturians, the Zeta Reticulans, and the Greys, all right? And the Pleiadians are all white light. Evidently, Maui's filled with Pleiadians, all right? The Arcturians are sort of more mischievous, but basically good. The Zeta Reticulans are the ones who probe people.
You also have the alien voice inside the mushroom.
So you've got two nice species and two evil species. And if you think about it, and authors have written about this, the way we used to think about the spirit world of angels and demons has roughly been transposed into modern quasi-scientific language into what we think of the alien.
You know, people are so alienated from their own soul that when they meet their soul, they think it comes from another star system. Beyond the expectations of linear reality, under the stimulation of psychedelic substances, we find that the world appears very much like Aboriginal people say it is. It's a world of spirits, invisible forces, languages of power, intuitive revelation.
The logic of a virtual world is closer to the logic of the dream time, the magical state of being.
For thousands of years, we've had virtual reality. Once you have language, language is the technology for the creation of virtual reality.
It's VR for a number of things, but I think that's one of the direct functions of VR is to act as this catalyst. In the same way that psychedelic drugs can act as a catalyst, or some sort of visionary or shamanic experience can act as a catalyst.
When you take mushrooms, it's the equivalent of taking a certain piece of software and running it on an operating system. Imagine the shamans sitting around the campfire telling the old stories, and everybody follows him in, and it's dark, and they see the pictures in their mind. This is virtual reality, run by its voice-directed VR.
So you think language is the way we see?
Yes. Language is the way we are. It is the way we are. We are linguistic creatures first and foremost. Language shapes the world. All of magic works by language.
So you'd sing...
Computers work by language.
You mean the stew of information in which the world is slowly being boiled?
Virtual reality is like magical reality in the sense that you can cast a spell and change the world. That spell might be written in C++ or Java,
but
it's no different.
While we're on this idea of changing the world with a spell,
right,
or a code,
right,
do you consider yourself a shaman?
Yes.
The shaman is the person who knows how the world really works. If you know how the world really works, you're a shaman. If you don't know how the world really works, then you're a citizen of some culture.
What's your definition of a shaman?
I've got a couple, certainly one. One is Terence's definition, someone who's been to the eschaton and looked it in the eye and is not so worried about it.
Now, for you that don't know what the eschaton is, it's kind of the end.
The shaman is the guy who is permitted to look under the board because he's been to the end and because he's been to the other side.
What is the end?
It's the impending climax of what we would think of as human civilization, although I would argue is probably the organization of life on Earth, is a global self-awareness. The eschaton does not contain category. It does not contain boundary. The eschaton cannot be described in words. It's one of those things. If you could describe it in words, you would be apt the eschaton. It's as if humanity is struggling to find a new word. And the root of that word is love, I know that, but the word itself has not been spoken yet. And that word, when it's spoken, changes the way we think.